Welcome to the Rare Plant Monitoring Program training. This training will be broken into numerous videos that walk volunteers through the process of preparing for a rare plant survey, conducting the survey, and submitting data. This video will discuss equipment volunteers may need or find useful during a rare plant survey. There are a number of things you should remember to bring with you in the field when conducting a rare plant survey. First, be sure to bring the maps that the program coordinator emailed you. You can either print hard copies of these or store digital copies on your smartphone or tablet, or have both as a backup. A handheld GPS unit is valuable for navigating and will be critical if there are GPS coordinates associated with the rare plant population. A GPS unit will also be necessary for marking the precise location of the rare plants if you find them. If you don't have a handheld GPS unit, a smartphone or tablet can also be used. Navigating to known GPS coordinates and marking GPS coordinates in the field will be discussed in detail in the navigation and submitting data videos. How will you take notes on the population size, habitat, and threats to the rare plant population? You can record data digitally using iNaturalist or the Survey123 apps, which will be discussed in the submitting data video. But if you'll be submitting data from your home computer, or on hard copy forms, then you will have to take notes in the field. This can be done either by bringing the data collection forms with you, copies can be found on the program website, or by writing in a field notebook and transcribing your notes later. If you do plan on submitting data digitally via iNaturalist or Survey123, be sure these apps are downloaded prior to heading into the field. They are free from the App Store, Google Play, or wherever you get your apps. A compass is another valuable tool for navigation. It's great backup even if you typically use a GPS unit, and in some cases can be easier for navigating off-trail long distances. We'll go over how to use a compass in greater detail in the navigation video. There are a few tools that can be nice to have when measuring a rare plant population. For example, a measuring tape is useful for measuring how much space the population occupies. Similarly, pin flags are useful for counting large populations and making sure plants aren't double counted. You can anticipate how large the population will be by looking at the associated data that comes with your survey assignment. In the EO data field, you can see what previous surveyors have found. And be sure to bring your camera or phone or tablet that can take pictures. Photographs are necessary to confirm that you found the species you said you found. Endangered and threatened species receive legal protection, and important and expensive management decisions are made based on assumptions about these species' status and location. It's critical, then, that the populations we are trying to protect have been correctly identified. When taking a photo of the rare plant you've just found, try and capture important identifying features that will allow it to be confirmed. This concludes the video on equipment to bring along on a rare plant survey. Please continue watching the remaining videos of the Rare Plant Monitoring Program to complete the training requirements.